time off. Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome. This is our final First Fridays program of the 21-22 season. So thank you all for being here for this. We're going to hear our organ scholars today, Simmons Easterling and Latimer Roglin. It's always fun to encounter a first, and I encountered that recently with the organ bench breaking. Never had that happen before, but anyway. So we have, we brought over the bench from the chapel, which is significantly shorter. So it has some 2x4s supporting it, which that's official bench raising material. But anyway, we have to, so we'll have to make an adjustment between our performers. So that's what's going on there. When you hear us shuffling things around. Well, before we get started, let's pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you for this time to gather together and to enjoy music, to enjoy your good gifts, and to see those students that you are raising up as musicians. We thank you for Simmons and Latimer and the gifts that you've given them and their desire to use those gifts for you. Pray that you would bless them in this time, and that you would be with us all and turn our hearts toward you, that you would receive the honor and glory for the music we hear. We pray this in your name. Amen. We will begin with Simmons.
Thank you. practiced earlier.
Thank you.
Well, it's the end of the year and graduation time and time of ceremonies, and we have a couple of ceremonies to do. I'll ask Roseanne to join me up here, Roseanne McDowell. A couple of years ago, Roseanne approached me with because she had the desire to start an Oregon scholarship for our Oregon Scholars program here. So it's for graduates, graduating Oregon Scholars are those who have graduated in the past and are studying Oregon in college. And so we awarded our first scholarship, McDowell Scholarship, last year, and excited to award the second one today. So Roseanne's desire for this was the scholarship is given in memory of her parents and sister and the musical legacy that her parents instilled in her family and siblings. And so to continue that legacy, particularly for church musicians, to do something to further music in the church. So last year, Ezra Blackwell was our first recipient, and this year, unfortunately, he's not able to be here because he's taking his last exam of the semester right now. But our recipient this year is Ryan Green. He graduated 2 years ago now, so he's finishing his second year at the Eastman School of Music. And I'll be presenting this to Ryan when he returns home. I think he's coming home tomorrow. And so Ryan is an organ major at the Eastman School of Music. And he'll be playing for us here. He'll be playing a service or two for us here over the summer. So thank you, Roseanne, for this wonderful gift and just for your love for music and for our organ scholars and for doing this for them and for our church. I very much appreciate it. And then if Latimer and Simmons would come back up here one more time. So just a little end of the year gift for them in recognition of all their hard work this year. What this is, we have at each lesson, they get a practice sheet telling them what they need to do, what they need to fix, work on. But at the top of the practice sheet, there's a verse, and at the bottom, there's a quote. So our theme verse this year was 1 Corinthians 10:31. So whatever you eat or drink, or whatever you do, do all to the glory of God. So it's more than the fact just that we are in a church, we're in a church context, but even in the eating and drinking of practicing, as it were, even those mundane day-to-day moments are done to the glory of God. So as a reminder of that, and to keep that in focus. And then beloved practice quotes. These are quotes from organists and philosophers and a variety of people, so I've included those in here so they can review them. Most of them are a little bit cheeky. Things such as Saint-Saëns, who said, one must practice slowly, then more slowly, and finally, slowly. The famous Suzuki, practice only on the days that you eat. So. Great reminders like that. So you use these in your practice to keep notes and track your progress, or use it however you like. But I'm very proud of you all, and to see where you've come this semester, and to hear your music today, and just encourage you to continue on in that prayerfully in the Lord, and continue to grow as musicians and in Him. So, thank you all for coming.